We're here with NeuVector. Can you give us an update on what NeuVector has been up to over the last 12 months?
Sure. Brian, thanks for having me. You know, NeuVector has been, you know, from the get-go, focused on runtime security for containers, and this year is no different. We're showing up at DockerCon here in San Francisco, talking about, you know, our runtime protection and why it matters and why it absolutely must have a network element in there to provide true protection in runtime.
And then you guys, obviously, you know, we're talking to you again. You guys were at DockerCon 2018. The show's back again. Now we're at DockerCon 2019. There are plenty of different shows now. That was one of the original container events. Now there's a bunch of, you know, different shows and options, right, as yep. containers grow. What brings you back to DockerCon?
You know, Docker was without question the pioneer in this space. They were the first company to sort of commercialize containers, and as such, they have a huge and very enthusiastic following, and there's a lot of, you know, movers and shakers in that crowd, and so that's why we're there.
Yeah, it's always good to be able to speak with intelligent people that, you know, have a lot of the same interests, and I think that's why a lot of these shows, it's all about the community, right?
Yeah, and you know, and there's also like some of the larger shows like AWS reInvent and Google Next. I mean, they're huge, and they're not all about containers. And you sort of drown out a little bit where this is super focused, right? And that's a good thing when you exhibit.
So what's going to be the focus of what you're showing off at the DockerCon event?
Right. So, you know, as I mentioned in the introduction, you know, NeuVector is all about, you know, runtime security for containers, right? And so, you know, Gartner is predicting that around 20% of enterprises right now are in production, and that number is growing to about 50 in the next year or two. So runtime security is becoming more and more relevant. And customers are starting to understand what it means to have proper runtime security. And so we're gonna show our wares and show how we protect not only the container by looking at processes and syscalls and files, but also how you absolutely must have proper layer 7 network security as a part of your runtime solution.
Yeah. So recently we've been hearing a lot about shift left security. First, can you tell me a little bit about what is shift left security and what your take is on this?
Yeah, Brian. So shift left is the notion that you're shifting the responsibility of securing an environment left, as in upstream. So you are putting more and more emphasis on having the developer formulating the security of their own application. You know, back in the sort of the old days, you had a very sort of delineated separation of church and state. So there would be a developer, there would be a production and operations, and there would be a network team and a security team. And that's all sort of, you know, blending nicely together. And so shift left is sort of moving the responsibility of the security further upstream. And our take on that is, you know, you absolutely must put some emphasis on the DevOps team to ensure that they clean up their code and they do not, you know, use old libraries and such. But at the end of the day, you know, proper security is an operations game. And you know, there are you know, people that are good at developing code, and there are people that are good at operating applications at scale, and they have conflicting interests. And so in our view, first you have to shift left and clean up your code, and then you got to shift right and make sure that you are secure in production.
And so I know at DockerCon I can expect that container security is going to be, you know, a hot topic. I know with VMblog readers, container security is hot right now. And I know you guys are focused on container runtime protection, and you've talked about that a little bit. Can you maybe give us a little bit more information about what you guys are talking about when you say container runtime protection, and then maybe explain for the folks who are watching this what that the difference is between that and what you guys are saying and selling, and maybe what your competitors are doing?
Yeah, absolutely. So, you know, there are sort of two areas of expertise when it comes to container security. There is the sort of the upstream expertise of scanning your containers. Typically, you're looking for CVEs, you're looking for configuration issues. There's the Kubernetes and Docker CIS benchmark. You're sort of trying to clean up your act as early on as you can. And our two main competitors, Twistlock and Aqua, are doing a decent job on the CVE scanning. On the sort of the other end of the spectrum, you've got the runtime security. And you know, that is basically monitoring the container while it's running, but also, you know, monitoring the environment around the container. You know, our notion here is that it's, if you see a malicious process, if you see a container that's trying to grab root, you know, the hacker is already in. It's too late. I mean, good luck. You found one instance, or where else is he? So, you know, the CVE isn't your problem. The hacker is your problem, right? And so we're trying to use best practices, you know, and using real network security with deep packet inspection and DLP and you know, looking at the payload to actually prevent a hacker from coming into your environment in the first place. And that's the main difference. You know, the other guys are very weak on network security. And it's been best practices for 20 years. I mean, if you look at modern day firewalls, you would never dream of deploying an old school layer 3 firewall in your environment today.
And kind of continuing on that thread, maybe we can take a deeper dive into container security, and, you know, why is runtime protection important, and how can enterprises, right, be able to make sure that they really do have true runtime protection?
Right. So runtime protection is important for sort of the obvious reasons that, you know, you're exposing your application to the internet, thereby you're exposing it to a public IP address, thereby you are vulnerable for hackers, right? I mean, in our own demo environments, whether it's Amazon or Google Cloud or IBM Cloud, we see port scans daily, right? Somebody is trying to find a way in. So that's the obvious, and that doesn't really, you know, differ that much from a, say, traditional operation. There are two other variables here that makes this, you know, very concerning when you sort of move a containerized application into production. One is that you just re-architected your application and you broke it down from one big sort of monolith that communicates with itself in memory to, you know, dozens of containers that are all now communicating on the network. So your network traffic, you know, inter-container traffic just exploded. And so that is a problem because you have zero visibility into all this newfound east-west traffic, right? And somebody's got to keep an eye on that and make sure that it's legitimate. And so that's one element. The other element is that it's a new environment, and with new environments come new mistakes, right? So you got to set up as many boundaries as you can, both on the networking side, but also on the, say, the runtime side. So you know, if you are being attacked, then first of all, you should try and keep the hacker out. And secondly, if he does come in, you should try and make sure that he can't move laterally around in your environment.
To put things into better context for people watching this video at home, can you maybe talk about what, you know, put that stuff into perspective and maybe give an overview of how a customer is actually using the NeuVector?
Yeah, absolutely. You know, we have tremendous momentum in the sort of highly security focused organizations such as finance, insurance, healthcare, you know, government, right? Those guys for the last 30 years have developed a lot of internal expertise around security, right? And so they appreciate when we come out and say, you know, runtime security must also contain, you know, proper network security. They appreciate that. And one of our customers is FICO that has, you know, it's a financial institution in Europe. And they recently deployed Linkerd actually as their service mesh. And on top of that, they realized that, you know, a service mesh isn't a security mesh, right? It's an intelligent routing mesh. And so as such, they were looking for a security layer on top of that. And we've been working with them for like the last 3-4 months to provide, you know, real layer 7 DLP, right? Because these guys are concerned about, you know, and rightfully so, your credit cards, your social security numbers, you know, your birthdays, your, you know, so, and that's what NeuVector can do over and above anyone else out there.
Put you on the spot here before we let you go.
Right.
Want to get your expert opinion on the container market. Just ask a couple questions like, you know, where do you see the industry heading? Are we on track for a growth spurt? I know we went to KubeCon and we heard a lot about, you know, growth and maturity of containers. And then in your opinion, too, with that is, are there any things that are holding back containers that we still need to overcome in order to get to that growth spurt?
Yeah, I mean, look, David, I think we're just getting started, right? So, you know, as I mentioned earlier, Gartner predicted, you know, that only 20% of enterprises are in production to some extent, right? And that's probably even a fairly large number. You know, we see that, but it's, you know, one application here, one application there. I think the growth spurt is like happening when you're taking, you know, the legacy application and re-architecting them. Right now, most of the organizations are taking 1 or 2 or 5 apps, but it's truly when sort of mainstream applications become containerized that that you see like a real growth spurt. I mean, it's very similar to VMware 15 years ago, right? Once companies started to put Exchange and SQL Server and sort of mainstream, you know, applications on VMware, they really took off. And you know, once you start moving classic sort of enterprise applications into a containerized environment, you know, a couple of things sort of pop up as being, you know, a serious, I wouldn't call it a roadblock, but at least something that you need to sort of, you know, look at. And so, you know, persistent storage, like what, for instance, Portworx is doing, is following that trend, right? I mean, most, you know, enterprise applications are requiring persistent storage, and that's hard when you have a very sort of ephemeral environment. And so that's one. And then two, the, you know, because these environments are so new and there are so few people that actually have operated, say, Kubernetes at scale, you know, security is a real sort of roadblock for, say, you know, a large scale rollout for most companies. So we feel pretty good about it.
Well, Henrik, I wanted to thank you for coming on and speaking with VMblog. Hopefully we will catch up again at some point during the year and at one of the other shows.
All right, it's great to be here, David and Brian. Thanks for having me.
All right, we'll have a good show, and we'll, like Brian said, hopefully we'll see you soon.
Yeah, absolutely.